Asia has 48 countries according to the United Nations, but for this video we're only counting 45 since I already covered Russia, Cyprus and Turkey's name in the European version of this video due to their partial belonging to that continent, and I'm including Timor in the one I make for Oceania. As usual, timestamps are in the description if you want to skip ahead to any country since this is a somewhat long video, and for each of these Asian countries I'm going to be looking at their name origin, how it came to be, what it means, and how it has, in some cases, changed throughout history. For Europe, we went west to east, and for America, we went alphabetically, so let's go east to west here, starting with the ones on the thumbnail. First, Japan. The name for Japan in Japanese is written using these kanji characters and pronounced Nippon or Nihon. I'm gonna mispronounce a lot of things in this video, by the way. Before it was adopted in the early 8th century, the country was known in China as Wa, and in Japan by Yamato. The characters mean sun origin and are therefore the source of the popular Western meaning attributed to Japan, land of the rising sun. The Western name Japan itself comes from either the old Chinese pronunciation of the characters as Sipangu or from the old Malay name for the country, Jepang, which the Portuguese brought back to Europe after their exploration of Southeast Asia. The English then translated a Portuguese letter referring to these lands, translating it to Japan, which eventually transformed into the current Japan. Then onto another archipelago, the Philippines. The islands were named by Spanish explorer Ruy Lopez de Villalobos. In 1542, he encountered a number of islands, naming specifically the islands of Leyte and Samar as Filipinas, after the then Spanish prince, soon to be king, Philip II. Eventually, this name was applied to all of the islands in the archipelago, which were at the time under Spanish possession. Moving to the Koreas, the only difference are the north and south elements, so we can cover the name origin of the two together. The name Korea derives from the name of the ancient 5th century kingdom of Goguryeo, and then the 10th century kingdom of Goryeo. It seems that around these times, visiting merchants from Persia adopted the name to Korea, but it seems to be a coincidence that this Persian translation is the same as the current English one, because the modern name of Korea apparently comes from the Portuguese maps from 1568, made by explorer João Vaz Dourado, who wrote the name of the peninsula as Konghai, with another explorer in 1630, then changing the name to Korea. Maybe this came from the Persian translation, maybe it came from the native way of describing it, I'm not sure. Eventually, the kingdom of Goryeo was replaced by the Joseon kingdom, and then Dayan Jeguk, which was the empire of Korea. Essentially, it seems that the Koreans themselves have always referred to their country in their own way, and like Japan, Korea was just the adaptation that Westerners created to refer to it. Going south to Taiwan, the island where Taiwan is located has had several names throughout history. Formosa, meaning beautiful, a name chosen by the Portuguese once again when they sighted the island in 1542, while Taiwan itself seems to come from the words Taiyan and Taiwan, the local terms used to refer to a specific location in the south of the island. This area is likely to have been named after the Taiwan people who are native to the land. Although its official name is Republic of China, differentiating itself from the People's Republic of China since the two sides opposed each other in the country's internal conflict of the 20th century. Before we go on with the video, a quick message from our sponsor and friend of the channel, Blinkist. Guys, I love Blinkist. I'm not even saying it because of the sponsorship. I actually pay for a Blinkist account ever since they sponsored the first video here on the channel. I got to know them and their service is just incredible. Everybody wants to read, but we either don't have enough time or our attention spans are so small because of all the fast media we consume, so we end up not doing it. Blinkist solves that problem. They take thousands of books and condense them into around 15-minute listening or reading sessions with all of the key points you need to know. They only do it for nonfiction books, so you can still spend all those hours reading chapter 14 of the Silmarillion, all of the mountain descriptions. Anyway, I even use it to find ideas for videos sometimes, or just to listen to topics I like, such as history, like this great one about the fate of the Roman Empire. The first 100 people to go to blinkist.com/generalknowledge get unlimited access for 1 week to try it out for free, and you'll also get 25% off if you want to continue with the full membership after that. Thank you to them for sponsoring the video. Now let's get back to the countries. And moving precisely to China itself, or the People's Republic of China rather, similarly to Korea, the adaptation of the name that eventually led to the Western version of it comes from Persia. The word China has been used since the 16th century, but it doesn't come from the Chinese themselves. In 1516, Portuguese explorer Duarte Barbosa published a journal, and in it, he referred to the land of China as such, but he didn't make up the name. It was derived from the Persian word Chin, which in turn came from the ancient Sanskrit dialect's word Sina, dating back all the way to the 5th or even the 2nd century. Most people claim Sina itself was a way of referring to the land under the rule of the Qing dynasty. This is unconfirmed, but a likely origin. The Chinese themselves refer to their country as Zhongwu, from Zhong, which means central, and Gu, which means state, although it could also be translated as Middle Kingdom, and it likely initially referred to the Western and then Eastern Zhou dynasties and their control over vast parts of China. Going north to Mongolia, Mongolia literally means land of the Mongols in Latin, and Mongols is the native word the locals use to describe themselves, but its origin is uncertain. There are various options, like it coming from the native name of a mountain or river, or from the Mongolian term Mongke Tengrigal, which means eternal skyfire, a pretty cool name if I'm being honest. But the most likely origin is that it comes from the name of a specific tribe, named by the Chinese as Mungu or Mungku, which then became known as the Kamag Mongol, a leading tribe, which eventually led to the creation of the Mongol Empire, causing all of the Mongol people to be known under this name. All the way south again to Vietnam, which is a variation of Nam Viet, literally meaning South Viet, and this name can be traced all the way back to the 2nd century. The term Viet was apparently first used by the Chinese and referred to a people or a chieftain in the area. Yue, as they pronounced it, was apparently even used by them to refer to non-Chinese people in southern China. Annam was apparently a common name for the area as well. But the region has had many names throughout history: Van Lang, Nam Viet, Annam, Dai Viet, Dai Nam, and then being a part of an area known during European colonialism as Indochina or Xochin China, until becoming known as Vietnam again. Close by is Laos. The term Laos was coined by the French, who united the three Lao kingdoms through their colony of French Indochina in 1893 and named the country after the most common native group, the Lao people. The origin of the name Lao itself is apparently unknown, and simply dates back to the name of an ancient tribe from which these people originated. In the Lao language, the country's name is Muang Lao or Pathet Lao, both of which literally mean Lao country. Still in the area, Cambodia. The English Cambodia is an adaptation of the French Cambodge, which in turn is the French translation of Kampuchea in the native Khmer language. Its origin comes from the ancient Sanskrit language and the joining of two words, Kambuja, which refers to the foundation myths of the first ancient Khmer kingdom, and Deza, which means land of or country of. So essentially, the name would be land of the Khmer, I think. Continuing south to Brunei. This one has a crazy origin, if we are to believe the story. Brunei was founded by Awang Alak Betatar. It is said the soon-to-be first sultan of Brunei was searching for a location in which he should establish the center of his domain. And when he arrived to the estuary of what is now the Brunei River, he, according to legend, exclaimed Baruna, which loosely translates as that's it, from which the name Brunei would eventually derive from. But a more likely explanation is that it comes from the 14th century word for the area, Barunai, which would come from the Sanskrit varun, meaning seafarers, with the word Borneo, the name of the entire island, having the same origin. And around it, Malaysia. A combination of the words Malays and the suffix ia, it can be translated as land of the Malays. An ancient kingdom existed in part of continental Malaysia called Melayu Kingdom around the 6th, 7th century, and it seems that is the first origin of Malay. But the origin of Melayu itself is uncertain. The main suggestion is that it derives from a Javanese word meaning to run, from the name of the Sungai Meliau River, but we can't really be sure, especially because it seems to have always had this name. In the 2nd century, Ptolemy's Geographia used the name Malayu Kulon to roughly describe the area. That Malayu kingdom also reached into the next country, Indonesia, joining two Greek words, Indos and Nezos, and meaning Indian islands. In 1850, George Windsor, an English researcher, proposed the term Indonesians and Malayunesians for the inhabitants of the Indian or Malay archipelago. It was also briefly known as the Dutch East Indies when it was ruled by the Netherlands during colonial times. Back to the mainland, the small city-state of Singapore. Singapore is an English adaptation of the Malay name Singapura, which was in turn derived from a Sanskrit word meaning lion city. Simha means lion and Pura means city or fortress. An ancient Chinese account from the 3rd century referred to it as Pu Luo Zong, which would translate to island at the end of the peninsula, an accurate description for its location. Under Japanese occupation, Sionan, meaning light of the south, then returning to Singapore when the occupation came to an end. Further north is Thailand. The country has always been called Muang Thai by its citizens, but for outsiders it used to be known as Siam, then changing it to Thailand. So we need to take a look at the origin of both of these. The word Siam may have originated from Suvarnabhumi, meaning land of gold in the Pali language. Another theory is that the name derives from the Chinese who called the region Xian, which the Portuguese converted into Siam. According to a French scholar, Thailand means free man in the Thai language, but an actual Thai scholar argued that it simply means people or human being, since his investigation showed that in some rural areas the word Thai was used as people instead of the usual Khon. Another country that changed its name, kind of, is Myanmar, previously known as Burma. Apparently in Burmese, the origin of the two words is common and even its pronunciation is similar, and it seems that many countries either still use Burma when referring to it or use both terms. So maybe saying that it changed its name is an overstatement. Both names derive from the earlier Burmese language, from the words Myanmar or Myama, a way of describing the Bamar natives, which mostly inhabited the region. West Bangladesh. Originating from Bangla, its exact origin is unknown, but some believed it comes from Vanga, an ancient kingdom which was located on the Ganges Delta. Religiously, it is said to come from Bang, a descendant of Noah, who would have initially colonized the area. The suffix Al apparently comes from mounds of land, which the ancient Rajas had raised from the ground, perhaps for defensive purposes. Other more straightforward theories state it means land of the Bengal, since the general area in which Bangladesh is located is known as such. And in fact, the Sultanate of Bengal from the 14th century included what is now the country. Going north, Bhutan. The precise etymology of Bhutan is unknown, but it's likely to derive from the way the native Tibetans referred to the area, Bod, more precisely, Bota Anta in Sanskrit, meaning the end of Tibet, since Bhutan is located on the southern extremity of the Tibetan plateau, and somewhat next to it, Nepal. According to Hindu mythology, Nepal derives its name from an ancient Hindu sage called Ne. However, some people who have studied the name state that Nepala was a joining of two local words, Nipa meaning foot of a mountain and Ala, short for Alaya and meaning abode, and so Nepal would mean abode at the foot of the mountain. It also has been proposed that the origin would be Nepa from Tibeto-Burman and joining the words of Ne, cattle, and Pa, keeper, since that was apparently an activity of the locals. It's interesting to see how many of these country names all over the world are just of unknown origin, simply having passed down from generation to generation without anyone apparently just writing down the reason why. Moving to one of the biggest countries in Asia, the name India is derived from the name of the river Sindhu or Indus and has been in use since Greek writer Herodotus first used it in the 4th century. It was precisely the ancient Greeks who began referring to the ancient Indians as Indoi, meaning people of the Indus River Valley. Bharata seems to be the native word for India, and please correct me if I'm wrong, but it is said to be derived from the name of an important religious figure, and a smaller island south of it, Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka has had many names throughout history as well, from Tambapani, meaning copper red earth. Ancient Greek geographers called it Taprobana. The Portuguese named it Ceylon, which the English then translated to Ceylon. The origin of Ceylon seems to be the Latin Ceylon, which the Romans would have named it. But did the Romans even know about Sri Lanka? I thought they hadn't established communications with people that far away. The current name of Sri Lanka divides itself into Lanka, the ancient name of the island, and Sri meaning resplendent, so resplendent island. Also islands, but many smaller ones, the Maldives, which probably get their name from the Sanskrit word Maladvipa, meaning garland of islands. From Mala, garland, and Vipa, an island. Garland means a wreath of flowers. I had to go look it up. Back to the mainland, we have Pakistan. The name of the country was coined in 1933 as an acronym referring to the names of the 5 northern regions of the British Raj: Punjab, Afghania, Kashmir, Sindh, and Baluchistan. If translated literally, it means something like a land abounding in the pure, in reference to the word pak, meaning pure in Persian, and Pashto, and the suffix istan, which means a place abounding in, so like place of X. This is why so many of the country names in these areas end with istan. And now precisely to the Central Asia istans, starting with Tajikistan. Tajikistan means land of the Tajiks. Tajik is most likely the name of a local tribe which lived there in the 7th century. The title Tajik also served to differentiate these people from the abundant Turks or Mongols that lived in the region. Then Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan is believed to come from the Turkish word for 40, referring to the 40 clans of Manas. Manas is a legendary local hero who supposedly united 40 regional clans against an external invader. And literally, Kyrgyz means we are 40. Kazakhstan. Kazakh also has a Turkish origin. It means to wander, reflecting the Kazakh's nomadic culture. The term Cossack, often well known for the role of the Cossacks in Russian history, especially military-wise, has the same origin. Uzbekistan has the common istan suffix, meaning land of something, but this something has three options. Apparently, the exact origin is unknown. It either means free / independent, joining the Turkish words uz meaning own and bek meaning master, being your own master, or it comes from the name of Oguz Khan, a legendary Khan of the Turkish people, or from the local Oguz tribe. And Turkmenistan, which has two possible origins that are completely opposite to each other. It could either come from Turk plus the suffix men, meaning almost Turk in reference to their status outside the Turkish dynastic mythological system, or it could mean the Turkish Turks, as in the real Turks. Some religious chroniclers have also suggested that it came from the word Turk and Iman in reference to a massive conversion to Islam of the territory in the 10th century. Also in Istan, but not usually associated with that group of ones we just saw, Afghanistan. The root name Afghan is, according to some, derived from the name of the Azvakan, ancient inhabitants of the region, while Azvakan literally means horsemen or horse breeders, so cavalrymen. Closing in on the Middle East, Iran. It derives directly from Middle Persian Eran, meaning Aryan, and so it's sort of land of the Iranians. As far as I could understand, Iran has always been Iran to the native population, but historically it was referred to as Persia by the West, apparently due to the writings of Greek historians, who refer to the region as Persis, meaning land of the Persians. In 1935, they requested that the international community should refer to the country by its native name, Iran, and with a very similar name, but with a different origin, Iraq. Iraq probably has one of the oldest continuous names. The Arabic version has been in use since at least the 6th century. There are several suggested origins for the name. One dates to the ancient Sumerian city of Uruk, another is from the Middle Persian word Erak, meaning lowlands, and the traditional meaning associated with it means well-watered and fertile. Onto the Caucasus region, we have Azerbaijan, which seems to get its name from a nobleman of the ancient Achaemenid Empire called Atropats. The name Atropats itself is the Greek translation of an old Iranian name, with the meaning protected by the holy fire. There are also some theories that the name would derive from the Zoroastrianism religion. Then Georgia, which probably stems from the Persian designation of the people who inhabited that region, Gurgan. This term itself might have been established through the ancient Iranian designation of the land by the Caspian Sea, which was referred to as Gurgan, land of the wolves. But it could also just be a translation of the saint, which was apparently extremely popular among the local population, Saint George. And also Armenia. The original native Armenian name for the country was Aik, with the Persians even calling it Ayastan at one point. And this Aik name would come from Aik himself, the legendary patriarch of the Armenians and great-great-grandson of Noah. When it comes to the modern Armenia itself, the origin is uncertain and has many options. The Indo-European Ar, meaning to assemble, the Bronze Age state of Armanum, from Armeni, meaning the mountainous region of the Mini, which is apparently a biblical name for the region, and some even speculate there was a Bronze Age tribe called the Armans, who would have originated the name. Onto the Mediterranean coast, Syria. Syria's name seems to come from the ancient name of Assyria in northern Mesopotamia, which in turn derives from the ancient Akkadian word Assur, precisely the capital of the ancient Assyrian Empire. I couldn't find the official origin for this, but it seems Assur was the name of an Assyrian god representing the sun, so maybe that could be the origin. Then Lebanon, which seems to be named after Mount Lebanon, located in the country. The name of the mountain comes comes from the Phoenician root Ibn, meaning white, in reference to the snow at the top of it. Moving to Palestine, it has been used as a term for a very long time, to refer to the general region in which the state is located. Historically, it seems to date back at least to the times of ancient Greece, with Herodotus being the first historian to write in the 5th century BC about a district of Syria called Palestine. The term itself, in Latin Palestina, is thought to have been coined precisely by the ancient Greeks to describe the area occupied by the Philistine people, first being used as Philistia and then evolving to Palestine. Although some say it might come from a native word, Peleshet, which would roughly translate to migratory, also referring to the Philistine people. And then Israel, under the British Mandate, the whole region was known as Palestine. When Israel became a state, it chose this name, from the Hebrew name Yisrael, meaning something like God contends. In the Old Testament, Israel, who was formerly named Jacob, wrestles with an angel, apparently. To the west is Jordan, which takes its name from the Jordan River, which forms much of the country's northwestern border. The origin of the river name itself seems to be the ancient word Yarat, meaning the descender, reflecting the river's path. And onto another big country, Saudi Arabia. With the joining of the kingdoms of Hejaz and Nayd, it was named the Saudi Arab Kingdom. Usually, it is commonly known as Saudi Arabia. The word Saudi is derived from the element As-Saudiya in the Arabic name of the country, formed from the dynastic name of the Saudi royal family, the Al-Saud. Its inclusion expresses the view that the country, an absolute monarchy, is under the possession and control of the royal family. Moving to the small nation of Kuwait, in the 4th century, the Bay of Kuwait was colonized by Alexander the Great, and the Greeks named it Larissa. Eventually, it became a colonial fortress of the Portuguese in 1521. The Hindustani word for fort was Kut, and so that would eventually become Kuwait. Joining 7 Emirates, the United Arab Emirates. The most well-known are Abu Dhabi and Dubai, but there are 5 others. Ajman, Fujairah, Ras Al Khaimah, Sharjah, and Al Quwain. UAE means precisely that. It's a union of Arab Emirates. An emirate is a political territory ruled by a dynastic monarch, an emir. But what about the names of these individual emirates? Abu Dhabi means father of Dhabi, a type of gazelle common to the region. Ajman is named after its capital city, which apparently derives from the Persian word ajam, meaning non-Arab. Dubai might come from the word daba, which means to move in slowly, referring to the slow waters of the Dubai Creek, but there are also other options. Fujairah takes its name from a stream that runs through the land. Ras Al Khaimah in English means top of the tent. Sharjah might come from the name of an idol worshipped in the ancient era, or from its location east, shark in Arabic, of Dubai. And Al Quwain is said to mean mother of the two powers. Not part of the UAE, but pretty much adjacent to them, Qatar. A Roman writer called Pliny the Elder wrote in the 1st century about the inhabitants of this peninsula, and he referred to them as Qatahe, likely coming from the name of a local settlement. A century later, Ptolemy drew the first known map of the region, referring to it as Qatara. The name evolved to Qatr, Qatar, among others, until reaching the current Qatar. Next, Oman. With an uncertain origin, the most likely hypothesis is that the name comes from the way Pliny the Elder and Ptolemy described the region in ancient times, Omana and Omanon, respectively. In Arabic, the name of the region is typically seen as coming from the terms Aman or Amun, which means settled people, as opposed to the nomadic Bedouin. Others say it was named after local historical figures, and some even say it was from the name of a valley in Yemen, presumably the place of origin of the tribe, which would have migrated to Oman, founding the country. And finally, Yemen. Yemen might come from the ancient Yamnat, which was in the title of one of the kings of the second Imyarit kingdom, known as Shamar Yarish. The term probably referred to the southwest coastline of the Arabian Peninsula. Although Yemen could also derive from Yimt, meaning south, or from Yamn or Yumn, meaning felicity or blessed, as much of the country is fertile. In ancient times, the Romans even called it Arabia Felix, fertile Arabia. And so, those are the name origins of each Asian country, again, what they mean, how they came to be used, and how they have sometimes changed throughout history, as well as the differences that exist between the way we internationally refer to the country, usually in English, and the way the countries refer to themselves in their own languages. I think I didn't forget any country, please let me know if I did, and also leave a comment if you notice any mistakes in the name origins and meanings, or if you just have any additional information. Thanks so much for watching, subscribe if you want, and I will see you next time for more general knowledge.